focus as the technical director is taking the set of drawings that we receive from the scenic designer and put a total figure, a dollar figure, on all of those materials. I also take all of the design drawings that are provided by the set designer, and I break them down into construction drawings, showing my carpenters how everything needs to be built, where all the framing is, what the framing is, how big it is, what materials were being used, and all the steps that are involved in putting that in a particular piece together. We had the advantage with this one, with things being a little different simply because it is a revival. We were able to pull out old photographs and videos and some of the old paperwork from when it was produced the first time around and kind of see what was done then, whether we could make any changes to make it better.
If you think about props in general, you think if you move into an unfinished apartment, the walls and such are your set. Everything else you bring in, other than the clothes you're wearing, are going to be props. One of the most difficult things is they'll want a chair that's light enough so that an 8-year-old can carry it with one hand, but an actor is going to stand on it, and then it's going to get a leg broken off it. IRMA VEP is presenting its own challenges. Because I'm working off of photographs, it's really hard to figure out dimensions. We don't have drawings for it. So it's a lot of educated guessing and a lot of design on my part and my staff's part. We're walking a line in that we know that stuff is supposed to be somewhat cheesy, but yet we also want to put the best thing that we can on stage. This production was done 11 years ago. We've become much more sophisticated. So some things I look at and I'm just like, I can't put that on stage. I just can't do it. Even some of the pieces that we have, we are going to be rebuilding because I know that we can do them much more stylish and stylistic than what they were done originally.
A scenic painter, it's this strange combination of a fine artist, an illustrator, a designer, a house painter, a construction worker, and then you need a lot of stamina because sometimes you have to do 12 plus hour days. For those that could remember things that worked and didn't work in the last one, they would mention, oh, the camel can look so good. What about this pyramid? You might be able to come up with a cartoon for that, or we noticed that the hieroglyphs on the column kind of repeat themselves, so if you want to get a little crazy towards the shadowy parts, you might be able to do that. And so I did. I threw in some extra bananas or this or that, just to have fun with everybody. This designer leans towards the purple. So there's a little bit of purple in everything in this set. It's probably the most cartoon of all the shows we've done. In all the windows and doors, there's not one right angle, and all the foam work.
Our job is what I like to call the craft part of it. The designer comes up with a set of sketches or a collage of photographs or however they choose to present it. Our job is to turn that two-dimensional thing into a three-dimensional object. All of the dresses that are in the show are all the same basic shape. Every single one of them opens and closes exactly the same way. You can't really tell when you look at them because they all are different fabrics, but basically all of the necks are the same, all of the sleeves are the same. That's one of the ways they can pull off the changes. You have two actors who play between them 8 different characters who change their clothes 48 times. And I think the quickest change was 1.7 seconds. We had to watch a DVD to remind ourselves of why and how we had to do certain things and how we pulled some stuff off.